guy on the net thinks.
Everyone likes surprises, right? But sometimes you stumble across more than you bargained for, and it sticks with you. Like a hex. Or like a fucking curse you just can't shake off. In honor of Halloween, this week, I'm counting down the top 5 creepiest hidden shit in music. Personality. Like Mussolini and Kennedy. Number 5. At the end of Korn's debut album, you can hear an argument between a couple about a Dodge Dart's exhaust manifold, found on a tape in an abandoned house by Ross Robinson, the album's producer.
That is not made to regulate the fucking choke on back
and that's not the end loader.
That's so you can get pure fuel in there.
Mm-hmm.
So you start cranking it over.
I know what you're thinking. This countdown's like every other one on the internet. Always has to start out with that first one that isn't really that scary, but just kind of eases you into the countdown. You're right. This tape itself is not creepy. In fact, it's kind of funny.
Oh, God. You're a hard, hard woman to live with.
It was right here in the book. I would have
found it. Oh, you motherfucker, you asshole, you stupid son of a bitch, you showed it to me!
But if you think about it, really, just think about it. The producer found this audio on a tape, probably an unlabeled, unmarked tape, in an abandoned house. He doesn't know who these people are. He doesn't know where this tape came from. He doesn't even know if the tape is from the people who lived in the house. Those people could have owned that tape. So who are these mystery people? And the main question I have is, why were they recording this argument?
We're talking about
a Dodge Dart on slot 6.
You have lost your mind.
What are you talking about?
My God.
I always wondered what it would sound like if the Lockhorns had their own radio show. Number 4. On Nirvana's album Nevermind, there's a hidden track called Endless Nameless. Now don't worry, I'm not that big a pussy that I'd actually consider this song to be creepy. No, what I'm listing in this countdown is the song's parody. Yeah, let me tell you a little story, okay? I may be in 4th or 5th grade, right? And I'm doing my social studies homework. Probably, right? I don't remember. Sounds accurate. And I'm listening to Weird Al's Off the Deep End. Now already, if you've ever seen the cover of the album, it is a parody of Nirvana's Nevermind album cover. So I'm just sitting there, working away, with those cheap-ass headphones that came with the Sony Discman on my ears, and the album ends. And I don't notice. So I'm just still working away, and after about 10 minutes, I hear this. I'm not exaggerating when I say that those cheap-ass headphones flew halfway across the fucking room. Weird Al, you're a dick. Number 3. Does anyone remember Space Hog? Yes, thank you. But at the end of that album is a hidden track called Was It Likely? Now, I'm a big fan of a good hidden track. Something that they didn't feel was quite deserving of being on the official track listing, but they didn't want to throw it away, wasting all their hard work. This song? It's fucking shit. It has all the makings of something that'll creepy the fuck out at 12. It has a really small sample of someone saying a sentence over and over and over again, music that sounds like it's being played through a telephone or a fucking music box, and not to mention that weird moaning. And this goes on for like 5 fucking minutes. It doesn't deviate. The same loop, over and over and over again. And the only thing that dilutes its creepiness is to realize how much that moaning sounds like a straw being rubbed against the inside of a fast food soda cup lid. before, or not. You get the point. Number 2, ELO's Fire on High, the instrumental intro to their album Face the Music. This wasn't exactly the kind of stuff ELO was known for, and this backwards message, like a lot of the time, were meant to be satirical, making fun of the whole, oh, that backwards message is the devil craze. But what they didn't intend on doing is making it sound creepy as hell.
The music is reversible, but time is not. Turn back.
I sure would like to, but it can't be unheard. Would you really consider this to be satirical? Like, a joke? Cause it's pretty scary. It's right up there with those satanic messages. No one call any message satanic, per se. Like, all those bullshit backwards messages where it's not really clear what they're saying. Like, Led Zeppelin's Stairway to Heaven, or Queen's Another One Bites the Dust. This was intentionally recorded to be played backwards cause I knew people would fucking do it. Was their goal to scare people to never do it again? Cause, really, let's break this down. The music is reversible, but time is not. Turn back, turn back, turn back, turn back, turn back, turn back. It's ominous, it's foreboding, and it paints a weird mental picture. Like, who is this supposed to be giving me this cryptic warning? I know it's the band's drummer, but seriously, who would know that at the time? And he's telling me that time is not reversible, and that I'm essentially wasting my time listening to these backwards messages. It's a good point, but you could have made it in a far less creepy way. We are knights, Nobel Prize. Number 1. When I originally announced that I was going to be making this countdown, a lot of people mentioned Revolution 9 by the Beatles, and yes, while it is one of the creepiest things I've ever heard on an album, it's in plain sight. Or sound. It wasn't hidden, but this was. The final note of A Day in the Life would fade out, and then you'd hear this, until you made it stop. This would repeat endlessly on the original British release of Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band, made by the Run-Out Groove, looping back onto itself. Some argue that this little gem has the honorable distinction of being the first ever hidden track. But would you really call it a track? The horrifying audio is missing on the US release, but was later included on an album of Beatles rarities released in the US in 1980, and CD versions of Sgt. Pepper's from that point on. By popular demand, I'm sure. And the scariest part about it to me is that you don't know what it is. There is no fucking clue as to what it is. No one has ever said what it was. All they say is, it's laughter and gibberish. That can't be it. It can't just be laughter and gibberish. It's either played backwards, or it's played at a different speed. I don't know what the fuck it is, but no one's even trying to explain it. And that, to me, makes it the creepiest thing I've ever heard. Not to mention that right before that, they put a high-pitched noise on the album intentionally to piss your dogs off. What fucking assholes. I don't normally do Halloween-themed episodes, so I hope you enjoyed this one. I'll see you next week, but until then, this is Mues saying, hope you weren't planning on sleeping tonight.
Satan, destroyer of needles, ruiner of stereos!
'Talk about creepy shit you found on albums almost by accident or some other strange circumstance! Time! In an abandoned house. He doesn't know who these people are. He doesn't know where this tape came from. He doesn't even know if the tape is from the people who lived in the house. Those people could have owned that tape. So who are these mystery people? And the main question I have is, why were they recording this argument?
We're talking about
Dark on slot 6.
You have lost your mind.
What are you talking about?
My God.
I always wondered what it would sound like if the Lockhorns had their own radio show. Number 4. On Nirvana's album Nevermind, there's a hidden track called Endless Nameless. Now don't worry, I'm not that big a pussy that I'd actually consider this song to be creepy. No, what I'm listing in this countdown is the song's parody. Yeah, let me tell you a little story, okay? I'm maybe in 4th or 5th grade, right? And I'm doing my social studies homework. Probably, right? I don't remember. Sounds accurate. And I'm listening to Weird Al's Off the Deep End. Now already, if you've ever seen the cover of the album, it is a parody of Nirvana's Nevermind album cover. So I'm just sitting there, working away with those cheap-ass headphones that came with the Sony Discman on my ears, and the album ends. And I don't notice. So I'm just still working away, and after about 10 minutes, I hear this. Reversible, but time is not. Turn back, turn back, turn back, turn back, turn back, turn back. It's ominous, it's foreboding, and it paints a weird mental picture. Like, who is this supposed to be giving me this cryptic warning? I know it's the band's drummer, but seriously, who would know that at the time? And he's telling me that time is not reversible, and that I'm essentially wasting my time listening to these backwards messages. It's a good point, but you could have made it in a far less creepy way. We are knights, Nobel Prize. Number 1. When I originally announced that I was going to be making this countdown, a lot of people mentioned Revolution 9 by the Beatles. And yes, while it is one of the creepiest things I've ever heard on an album, it's in plain sight. Or sound. It wasn't hidden. But this was. The final note of A Day in the Life would fade out, and then you'd hear this. Until you made it stop. This would repeat endlessly on the original British release of Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band, made by the Run-Out Groove, looping back onto itself. Some argue that this little gem has the honorable distinction of being the first ever hidden track, but would you really call it a track? The horrifying audio is missing on the US release, but was later included on an album of Beatles rarities released in the US in 1980, and CD versions of Sgt. Pepper's from that point on, by popular demand, I'm sure. And the scariest part about it to me is that you don't know what it is. There is no fucking clue as to some guy on the net thinks. Everyone likes surprises, right? But sometimes you stumble across more than you bargained for, and it sticks with you. Like a hex. Or like a fucking curse you just can't shake off. In honor of Halloween, this week, I'm counting down the top 5 creepiest hidden shit in music. Number 5. At the end of Korn's debut album, you can hear an argument between a couple about a Dodge Dart's exhaust manifold, found on a tape in an abandoned house by Ross Robinson, the album's producer.
That is not made to regulate the fucking choke on back.
That's
before.
Not the end loader.
That's so you can get pure fuel in there.
Mm-hmm.
So you start cranking it over.
I know what you're thinking. This countdown's like every other one on the internet. Always has to start out with that first one that isn't really that scary, but just kind of eases you into the countdown. You're right. This tape itself is not creepy. In fact, it's kind of funny.
Oh, you're a hard, hard woman to live with.
It was right here in the book. I would have found it.
Oh, you motherfucker, you asshole, you stupid son of a bitch, you shot it to me!
But if you think about it, really just think about it, the producer found this audio on a tape, probably an unlabeled, unmarked tape. I'm not exaggerating when I say that those cheap-ass headphones flew halfway across the fucking room. Weird Al, you're a dick. We are knights, Nobel Prize. Number 3. Does anyone remember Space Hog? Yes, thank you. But at the end of that album is a hidden track called Was It Likely? Now, I'm a big fan of a good hidden track. Something that they didn't feel was quite deserving of being on the official track listing, but they didn't want to throw it away, wasting all their hard work. This song? It's fucking shit. It has all the makings of something that'll creep you the fuck out at 12. It has a really small sample of someone saying a sentence over and over and over again, music that sounds like it's being played through a telephone or a fucking music box, and not to mention that weird moaning. And this goes on for like 5 fucking minutes. It doesn't deviate. The same loop, over and over and over again. And the only thing that dilutes its creepiness is to realize how much that moaning sounds like a straw being rubbed against the inside of a fast food soda cup lid. Or not. You get the point. Number 2, ELO's Fire on High, the instrumental intro to their album Face the Music. This wasn't exactly the kind of stuff ELO was known for, and this backwards message, like a lot of the time, were meant to be satirical, making fun of the whole, oh, that backwards message is the devil craze. But what they didn't intend on doing is making it sound creepy as hell.
The music is reversible, but time is not. Turn back!
Well, I sure would like to, but it can't be unheard. Would you really consider this to be satirical? Like, a joke? Cause it's pretty scary. It's right up there with those satanic messages. No one called any message satanic, per se. Like, all those bullshit backwards messages where it's not really clear what they're saying. Like, Led Zeppelin's Stairway to Heaven. Or Queen's Another One Bites the Dust. This was intentionally recorded to be played backwards because I knew people would fucking do it. Was their goal to scare people to never do it again? Cause, really, let's break this down. The music is...